We need to understand why do we need something called as a file handling. Till now, whatever programs we run in C++ or any other language, we are running, we read some input, and as soon as the program is over, the variable's lifetime is over and you lose the values over there. So every time you are running the program, every time you need to enter those values. Just for example, you are creating a class student. You are reading various values about name, roll number, marks, etc., etc., etc. As soon as you're, and then you have your main. Within the main, you are creating objects, entering 10 student details. After entering 10 student details, you are performing some tasks. And as soon as you come out, the data is gone. So what happens is it becomes very clumsy. You are not able to store the data. Whatever data is there, it is acting in the primary memory. You are not able to connect to the secondary memory in any manner. So when you want permanent data, abhi tak jo bhi data hai, wo temporary data hai, wo jab tak program run ho raha hai, jab tak to data is available, as soon as the program execution ends, the variables also lose their complete lifetime and their values. Memory allocated has been free. So what I want is permanent data storage. So that every time I'm reading, whenever I've entered the student details, they retain in a file. So permanent data storage ke bahut sare method hain. One that we are going to use is something called as file handling. What we try to do in file handling is, we try to store the data in the form of files and save them in the computer. Now there are a lot of type of files available, and with other languages like Python, etc., you might be using a huge lot of files available to you. The files that we will be restricting ourselves will be text files and binary files. We will be restricting ourselves to this, but this also gives me a lot of opportunity to work in. We'll explain how this happens. Now, what do I mean by permanent data storage? I have written my data in the file. So whenever I need the data, I will open the file. I will read the data. If I need to update, I might be updating the data. And I just keep that file. All of you know that there are many files available in computers. Right from video files, music files, images, your text files, your project files, your files, your object files. Hmm? The permanent storage that you are creating, that can be used later on in the program. Now the question is, how do you connect your front end with this back end? See, this is what is happening. How do you connect your program with this permanent data storage? So that is, you do, for that you use file handling. For using file handling, we need to understand how a program would be working and what are the streams that are involved in between. So you have a program code and you have files in permanent storage. Theek hai, ye files hain jo aap create karoge, ho sakta hai bani hui file, ya aap koi new file banaoge, ya you are using some existing file, an old file. Whatever the case may be, there is a program code that is going to run and there is a section where the files are there. How do they interact? They interact through streams. So there is something called as an input file stream. And there is something called as an out. See, when you, the input lete hain, toh kya hota hai? Hum file se input le rahe hain. My arrow is the wrong direction. This is an input file stream. And then you have an output file stream. Jaise hamare paas I stream or O stream hai na, input and output stream. Similarly, we are having input stream, if input file stream and output. What is happening here is program is going to run in your primary memory. All of you know. प्राइमरी मेमोरी में आप कुछ प्रोग्राम है उसको रन करोगे, आपके रैम में इट इज रनिंग एंड एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग ऑन. फाइल इज अ परमानेंट स्टोरेज. फाइल या तो किसी डिस्क पे होगी, आपकी हार्ड डिस्क पे होगी, पेन ड्राइव में होगी, सीडी में होगी, इट इज सम फॉर्म ऑफ परमानेंट स्टोरेज दैट इट माइट बी हैविंग. सो दिस इज द सेकेंडरी मेमोरी दैट यू आर यूजिंग. इन शॉर्ट, the file is going to be there in the secondary memory, and you are having your program running in the primary memory. How do they communicate at runtime? So them to be available at runtime, you have to, even if you are using an old file, you have to open the existing file and then use it. If you are using a new file, you are creating it at runtime, the temporary file. After the program is over, you should be able to save the file in the permanent storage. To be able to do that, we have two streams, if stream and upstream, that are doing the work for us. Whenever we want to read from the files, we use the if stream, input file stream. Whenever we want to do some output, then we have the output file stream. Streams, we have already discussed once earlier. What are the stream going to do? They are acting as buffer. Jaise samajh lo, jab tak program chal raha hai, you are doing something, something, something. That is happening temporarily in the file. Once the program is over, what if you were making any changes or you were creating a new file, and what the offstream will do, whatever changes are done here, it is going to save them permanently in the file. Similarly, whenever you are reading the file, you will open the file in ifstream. Till the program is running, the file remains here for your usage. Whenever the program is over, ifstream is empty. So what is happening, you are using output file stream and input file stream acting as buffers for reading the data in between and opening. So you just say app simple samjho, there is a register that you want to read, simple file. You need to first of all locate the register. To pehle uski location pata honi chahiye, kaun si almira mein, kaun se cupboard mein, kaun se desk pe, kahan pe exactly wo file hai, you should know that na. Similarly, where in the computer your file is there, you should know that. If it is in the same directory in which you are working, then you can directly give the name. Otherwise, you need to give the entire path of your file. Jaise, for example, is the streams clear to all of you?
Ma'am, please ek baar bata do. What stream?
See, I again repeat the streams now. In the input output system that C++ is following, let us understand what is happening. Let's try to relook at this. We are having the input output system, right? When we are having an input output system, we are finally having your file stream. Some file stream base is there, which is going to connect to the stream files in somehow. So there are some buffers, etc. What is happening is, input output system is having some input stream. This is some I stream, input stream, right? And there is some output stream, jisse ki aap console se reading or writing kar rahe hain. Cout, Cin, that you have been using I stream and output stream automatically. And there is a stream buffer also. There is something called as stream buffer to temporarily hold the data. Now, finally, you have your input-output stream. All functions which are related to input-output stream are stored in your input-output stream.h, and that you have already been using. The basic means console input and console output. Now, I stream is the input stream which is also connected to the input file stream. This is also connected to input file stream. Similarly, offstream, output stream is also connected to the output file stream. Ab iska matlab kya hua? Connected hai, ye to theek hai. What does it mean? IO stream is connected to file stream. File stream means input output dono possible hai, file ka at the same time. And from your base, you are having the file through which you are performing these tasks. There will be a file buffer also. I do have a file buffer to temporarily hold a file. And stream buffer is connected to this file buffer. So technically, this is how iOS can be giving input to file stream base. So this is technically how the stream classes are functioning. Ab ye samajh lo, aise samajh lo, ye sab classes created hai aapke C++ mein. Aur inse related functions, members jo hain, wo usi class ke liye created aur unhi header files mein accordingly create kar diye gaye hain. This is the hierarchy of the stream classes in C++, right? सो देयर इज एन इनपुट आउटपुट स्ट्रीम जिसमें से आपने आई स्ट्रीम ओ स्ट्रीम जो ड्राइव कर ली, देन यू हैव द अंडरस्टैंडिंग, देन यू हैव द इनपुट फाइल स्ट्रीम, देन यू हैव द आउटपुट फाइल स्ट्रीम. अब ये सारी क्लासेस करती है. द क्वेश्चन इज, as I have told you earlier also, as soon as you press a key, key is pressed in very long time as compared to computer's processing. आप minimum fraction of second भी लोगे तो computer can process in nanoseconds, picoseconds. So the keys which are pressed are very very slow. Program read कैसे करेगा? ऐसे समझो, if I'm speaking very fast, how will you going to understand? अगर मैं आपकी सुनने की कैपेसिटी से तेज बोलूंगी तो आप नहीं सुन पाएंगे. सिमिलरली इफ आई एम स्पीकिंग अटरली स्लो, दिस इज कंपैरेटिवली वेरी स्लो, कंप्यूटर के केस में 1000 times 10000 times हो रहा है, इस बात को समझो. तो इफ आई एम स्पीकिंग वेरी स्लो देन आई एम ऑल्सो अगेन वेस्टिंग द टाइम ऑफ द इफेक्टिव प्रोग्राम. तो उसकी स्पीड को मैच करना है, करेक्ट डेटा को रीड करके आपके कंसोल से आपकी फाइल से प्रोग्राम तक पहुंचाना है, एंड वाइस वर्सा. दिस इज द वर्क डन बाय द स्ट्रीम्स. ये सारा काम करने के लिए वी हैव दीस क्लासेस अवेलेबल इन C++. वी आर इंटरेस्टेड इन आईओ स्ट्रीम, यू ऑल हैव बीन ऑलरेडी यूजिंग इनपुट आउटपुट स्ट्रीम. हेडर फाइल में इस क्लास के सारी डिटेल्स ऑलरेडी गिवन है. सी इन सी आउट ऑपरेटर्स यू हैव ऑलरेडी बीन यूजिंग दीस, एंड यू हैव बीन यूजिंग मेनी अदर फंक्शंस विद दीस क्लासेस, राइट. Similarly, to handle files, we have input file stream, we have output file stream, or we can say that we have F stream for handling both input output together. So, for my file stream base, we are having some various files available. What we need to be considered about F stream, either F stream or if stream or off stream, depending on how we are opening a file. If I am going to only write in a file, then I will take the output stream. If I'm only going to read from a file, then it is an input file stream, so on and so forth. Just for example, if you are opening a book, then you are reading it in an input file stream. If you are opening a register, it might already be having, if it is a new register, it's an output file stream. Now you're opening an old register in which you want to read the data also, and you want to write some data also. Maybe you want to update some data also. In that case, you are opening an F stream, which can do both input and output. That's the file stream. Is the concept of streams now clear to all of you? There are a few things that you need to understand. How do you open a file? First of all, you need to know where the file is. Where is the file? When you want to open a particular file and use it, so you know, want to know where the file is, koi register hai, kaun si cupboard mein rakha hai, etc. So you want the exact path of the file. Either it is in the same working directory, or you will want to know the exact path of your file, whichever the case may be. Ab if I know where the file is, to file chal ke to mere paas aayegi nahi. Kaise aayegi? I will be taking out a hand, picking up the file, and then reusing it. So this my hand is going to work as a handle for the file. I need to create a handle. What is this handle? This is an object of some class, either if stream or off stream. किसी ना किसी type का object चाहिए मुझे. So this is a class object which acts as a handle to that file. चाहे उसमें लिखना हो चाहे नहीं लिखना हो. File अपने आप चल के नहीं आएगी ना आपके पास. हाथ से उठा के लानी पड़ेगी, हाथ से pages को open करना पड़ेगा, हाथ से जिस page पे लिखना है वो सब कुछ काम वो handle करेगा. आपका हाथ करता है ना, फाइल को लेके भी आएगा, खोलेगा भी, द पेज वेयर एग्जैक्ट लोकेशन इस पेज में आपको जहां पे लिखना है, एक्सेट्रा, एवरीथिंग दैट इज गोइंग टू बी डन बाय दिस हैंडल. ये क्लियर हो गया? नाउ यू शुड नो यू आर ओपनिंग द फाइल फॉर रीडिंग और राइटिंग और बोथ. आपको खाली पढ़ना है फाइल में से, इट इज एन इनपुट फाइल. खाली लिखना है फाइल में, इट इज एन आउटपुट फाइल. यू हैव टू डू बोथ, देन इट इज एन इनपुट आउटपुट फाइल. Right, accordingly you have to open the file in particular mode. Since we are opening by hand, we will see and decide whether we want to look from book or not. But if we are only reading a book and we are not going to write anything, then we don't need a pencil. If we want to write something, we will need a pencil. That is why we only open in reading mode or writing mode if only that task is to be performed. This handle is something that is going to handle everything. अब file मिल गई, ये रही मेरी file, handle हाथ है मेरे पास, इस हाथ में ये file आ गई cupboard में से, ठीक है? Now I have, it is only the file which is now I have got it from the path. I have to open this file at the correct page. बिना open करे I will not be able to write in it. So I have to open it file. And once I have written everything or read everything from it, I need to close the file. Close करके वापस रखना भी तो पड़ेगा उसे. This is what you do when you use registers. Register, book, कुछ भी किसी भी चीज से पढ़ते हो, this is what you do. Same thing we do in C++. Just with digital path, digital handle, digital opening and digital closing. That is the only difference. इसके लिए सब चीजों के लिए यही steps हैं. यही step आप भी करते हो. These are the steps we will be following. Just in the form of C++ syntax. Is the basic clear to all of you? Now I need to first of all know where my all the classes are created so that I can use them and create objects. So xstream.h file handling ke program mein you need to include this header file. So you will be including hash include fstream. This is the header file that needs to be included. After including this file, there are various functions to open the file. Generally, since it's a class object, कौन सी class है? दो classes है, अभी बताया था मैंने, एक है class ifstream और एक है class offstream. In case you are opening a file for writing, supposedly you are opening some out file, this is the object that you are creating. So it is something that you are creating of type offstream. This is the class, right? Now opening can be done using the constructor. So this is, you are not using any other function. You are using a constructor of the class to open a file. Out file क्या है? सिर्फ handle है. ये जो object है ना, this is acting only as handle. अब ये handle ध्यान रखना आपके हाथ की तरह है. अब हाथ में कोई भी file हो सकती है. At a time एक ही file है. At a time एक ही फाइल है एक हाथ में, understanding? So at a time your handle will handle only one file, but same handle can close that file and open another file. Same handle can be used as your hand. So what you are going to do is you are now, अभी तक हमने क्या करा? अभी तक हमने सिर्फ handle create करा है. Now when in the constructor you pass some name, supposedly file one, I am passing a name file one, assuming that it is in the same working directory. This file one, if existing, will open. Since I am opening an output stream, we'll discuss about the modes very shortly. If I am opening in the output stream, so in that case, if a file is not existing, a new file will be opened, right? So using the constructor, you are opening file one, or file one, कौन से हाथ में है? Outf नाम के हाथ में रखी हुई है, right? So this is the handle that is going to handle this file. आपको कौन सा पेज चाहिए, वेयर यू हैव टू राइट, आगे पीछे कहां आपको जाना, वट एवर दैट हैंडल विल डू एज योर हैंड डज सेम वर्क. दिस इज द फाइल नेम दैट यू आर ओपनिंग यूजिंग द कंस्ट्रक्टर. सो दिस इज हाउ यू विल बी ओपनिंग अ फाइल. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू क्लोज अ फाइल, वट विल यू डू? यूजिंग द हैंडल, दिस इज एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ द क्लास, यू कॉल द फंक्शन क्लोज. दिस विल, वट विल इट डू? आपके हाथ से वो रजिस्टर उठा के वापस अलमारी में रख दिया आपने. ओपन में यू गो, इफ इट इज नॉट इन द सेम वर्किंग डायरेक्टरी यू नीड टू गिव द एंटायर पाथ ओवर हियर. सो ओपनिंग इज फेचिंग द फाइल एंड ओपनिंग इट. क्लोजिंग इज यू पुट इट बैक इनटू द अलमीरा. अब आपका हाथ खाली हो गया, हैंडल इज फ्री नाउ. सो हैंडल कैन हैव अनदर फाइल. यू कैन यूज सेम ऑब्जेक्ट आउट एफ to open another file and point it to another file also. I hope I am making myself clear. This is how you are opening a file using constructor. This is how you can close a file. Now this is only opening and closing. How do I write in a file? For example, I have opened the file in the output stream. How do I write it? It is very simple. The same as you do cout, in a very similar manner you can do. आपने सपोजिटली दिया आउट ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट बनाया है, आप ऑब्जेक्ट में यू कैन डायरेक्टली यूज द operator. You can directly use your output operator here. And what if supposedly you are mentioning hello first file? So you can directly mention it here. As you are mentioning on console, you can give a backslash and the new file, or you can use any variable name, whatever you want to write here, and so on and so forth. You can write an entire object of another class to a file also. Just a student class create kariye, uska pura ka pura object you can store using this. So this is the simple method using the output operator. How do you write in the file? So using the handle, using the hand, you write na, haath se likhte hai na. Ye kya hai operator? Ye pen hai. Operator is your pen. क्या लिखना है? That you are mentioning. So you have the handle, your handle, operator, that is the pen, and then you are writing. I hope the things are getting clear. The method is getting clear. Similarly, instead of opening the file in output mode, supposedly if you are opening it in input mode, you are reading a file. So I'm just changing the name. It can be any name. Supposedly it is input file. Again, the handle is there, and you can open and close it in the absolute similar manner. Sirf handle ka name change kara hai maine. So you are opening if stream matlab reading ke liye file open ho rahi hai. Name anything you are giving, that is the name to your hand, and this is the name of the file that you need to fetch. After opening, before closing, you are going to do something. Inke beech mein sari functioning hogi. So before closing, as you are reading. In a similar manner, as you are writing, in a similar manner, you can read from the file. In file, you can read supposedly name, or in file, you can read entire line. आपने कोई character array बना दिया 80 character का, पूरी की पूरी line जो भी आपकी file में लिखी है, you can read that, and so on. Similarly, the handle, कौन सा page खोलना है? This act as your eyes. आप पढ़ोगे कैसे? आईज से पढ़ोगे ना. सो दीज आर योर आईज ऑपरेटर, इनपुट ऑपरेटर, एंड देन वट एवर यू आर गोइंग टू रीड. सो दिस इज हाउ यू रीड एंड यू राइट इन अ फाइल. जस्ट एक्सप्लेनिंग द सेम विद अ वेरी स्मॉल एग्जाम्पल, विद अ प्रॉपर एग्जाम्पल प्रोग्राम कोड. इफ आई वॉन्ट टू क्रिएट अ फाइल विद कंस्ट्रक्टर फंक्शन, ओपन फंक्शन भी है. आई एम यूजिंग कंस्ट्रक्टर फंक्शन राइट नाउ. So you are having hash include your IO stream. You are also having here hash include F stream. File stream is also included, and you are using namespace STD. Right. After doing this, you are having a void main. Let's see this example here. You are opening a, पहले आप लिख रहे हो फिर पढ़ रहे हो इन दी. सो यू आर क्रिएटिंग अ फाइल एंड देन यू आर गोइंग टू रीड इट. सो आई एम ओपनिंग अ फाइल इन ऑफ स्ट्रीम मोड. आई एम ओपनिंग सपोजिटली द सेम फाइल दैट आई एम ओपनिंग, एंड आई कैन गिव इट एनी नेम ऑफ माई चॉइस. सो आई एम सपोजिटली मेंशनिंग इट एज फाइल F1. राइट नाउ सी दिस इज सी आउट, नॉट आउट F. सो दिस इज माई कंसोल आउटपुट. On the screen, I am printing. Kindly enter the name. You want to save something in the file. Supposedly, some name is to be saved in the file. You create character name 30 supposedly, and you are reading the name from the user using the keyboard here, right? And now this name you want to write in the file F1 using the hand out F. So out F use करके output operator is your pen. Using this output operator, you are writing name. The name लिख दिया आपने file में, right? And supposedly you give a new line after the name so that you can have different names written in different lines. Along with the name, आपको कोई भी और detail देनी है, roll number, choice, etc. Price, whatever other details, supposedly you are mentioning other details, roll number, just taking for example, right? And you are having an integer roll number, and you are reading from the user. So you are reading this roll number from the user. after reading the roll number from the user, you want to write the roll number also into the file. So what do? File ka handle, pen, and you want to write roll number. You can also give a new line if you want after this. अब फाइल का काम खत्म. हमें दो ही चीजें लिखनी थी सपोजिटली, नेम एंड रोल नंबर. सो आफ्टर राइटिंग दिस नेम एंड रोल नंबर, आई एम क्लोजिंग द फाइल. हैंडल से फाइल को वापस रख दिया कबर्ड में यूजिंग द क्लोज फंक्शन. सो दिस इज द ऑब्जेक्ट कॉलिंग द क्लोज फंक्शन डिफाइंड इन द ऑफ स्ट्रीम क्लास. तो आउटपुट स्ट्रीम की फाइल आउट एफ जो है, जो कि फाइल वन को हैंड पॉइंट कर रही थी, दैट हैज बीन क्लोज्ड नाउ. राइट, now I am creating an object of input stream. So I, if stream ka object I am creating, and I am opening the same file in input stream so that I can read the contents of my file. So to be able to read the contents of the file, I have opened it in if stream. Now I am reading the contents name, and I am reading, see, I am reading using the handle. Haath se wo page khola hai. ऑपरेटर से आई एम रीडिंग, पहले नेम रीड करा है, फिर आई एम रीडिंग द रोल नंबर. सो आई हैव रेड बोथ द थिंग्स फ्रॉम द फाइल, एंड आफ्टर रीडिंग आई कैन प्रिंट द सेम थिंग्स यूजिंग सी आउट माय कंसोल आउटपुट कंटेंट्स ऑफ फाइल. सो कंटेंट्स आई कैन प्रिंट नेम, एंड आई कैन प्रिंट द नेम हियर, सिमिलरली रोल नंबर. And I can print the roll number. You can have other details. I've just taken a small example here. Finally, after reading, file is not required. Handle se haath se file ko wapas rakh diya cupboard mein. So you close the file using the close function, and you end the main function. So after you are done with the program, what will happen is, you are creating an offstream object here, opening a file using the constructor of the class. You are closing this file here. In between, you are writing the name in this line, and you are writing the roll number in this line to the file. ये सब file का work है. बाकी सब तो you have been doing in C++ earlier also. After writing the file, आपने वापस रख दी. Now you need to again open the file for reading. Read mode में contents को read करा आपने. आपने वट एवर प्रिंट करके, एंड देन फाइनली यू पुट द फाइल बैक इन द कवर्ड, एंड योर प्रोग्राम इज ओवर. टिल हियर इज इट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? आर यू ऑल अंडरस्टैंडिंग टिल हियर? एनीबडी एनी डाउट्स प्लीज आस्क.